up, this is Nainia from Tekbatic Solutions, and today I will teach you how to make your non-wireless printer wireless using a Raspberry Pi. This is going to be slightly complicated as well as slightly simple. I will try to make it as simple as possible. Now coming to the reason why I am doing this. First, the new wireless printers are really expensive. The second reason is that I am using my printer for the last 8 to 9 years and it has not given me any issues. The only issue was the printer's ink, which used to drain off every now and then, but that's pretty much fine because I print like 20 pages a month, which is less than a page a day, and I would like to improve, or I would say increase, the longevity of my printer using the Raspberry Pi. So let's proceed with the tutorial, and I hope this helps many people. So let's begin. Before I begin the tutorial, you need to make sure that your Raspberry Pi is connected to the Wi-Fi using a Wi-Fi USB adapter. Now I'm using the Edimax Nano Wi-Fi USB adapter for my Raspberry Pi. You can get that too. And if you want to know about how to connect your Raspberry Pi to Wi-Fi, you can check out my previous tutorial and it will help you. It's for open networks as well as hidden networks. So go ahead, connect your Raspberry Pi to your Wi-Fi network. And once you're done with that, we need to SSH into our Raspberry Pi. So I will just SSH to my Raspberry Pi. The default password is Raspberry and the default username is Pi. That's why I said SSH Pi at 192.168.2.11, which is my IP address of my Raspberry Pi. And then now we have SSH'd, we need to first proceed with the common steps, that is sudo apt-get space update, and it will get all the new packages, and this might take a bit of time, so just hang on, I'll be right back once this is done. Once you have updated the packages, the next step is to upgrade them. So we'll type in sudo apt-get space upgrade, and this will again take quite a lot of time, so just hang on, I'll be back once this is done. The next step is to install the open source file sharing server, that is the Samba file sharing server. So you'll type in sudo apt-get space install space Samba, and this should install the Samba file server, and this shouldn't take much time, so this should be pretty quick. Now we need to install the CUPS printing service, because that is the service which allows us to print on Mac and on your Unix devices. And as you know, Linux derives many things from Unix, so this will work with your Raspberry Pi too. So we'll type in sudo space apt-get space install CUPS. Now we need to decide who will be the default user who will print using the Raspberry Pi. And on my Raspberry Pi, I have only one user, that is the Pi. So I will make it the default user using the following command: sudo usermod -a -G space lpadmin space Pi. And when I press enter, Pi will become the default user for printing using my Raspberry Pi. Now we need to ensure that our printer is connected to our Raspberry Pi through the USB port. So we will just use the command lsusb and verify that. And you can clearly see that device number 5 is nothing but my printer itself. That's HP OfficeJet 5600 series. Once you have checked the USB connections on your Raspberry Pi, you need to switch off the SSH connection and connect to the graphical user interface of your Raspberry Pi through a computer screen or a TV screen. In that, open a web browser on the Raspberry Pi and go to your local loopback address with the port number 631. This will open the CUPS printing server and you can manage the entire printing through this server. Next step is to go to the administration page. Once you go to the administration page, you need to perform some changes in the server settings. That's right on the right hand side of the web page. And these are the settings that you need to perform. Just checkmark these settings and click on change settings. Once you click on Change Settings, it will say that please stand by while the server restarts. Once the server restarts, it will take you back to the loopback address with the port number 631. Now you can switch off your Raspberry Pi and reconnect via SSH. Now we will access the Raspberry Pi printing service, or you could say the server, wirelessly, and we will go into the administration section again. We'll click on Add Printer and it will ask us to access the website through HTTPS, which we will do, or it will automatically redirect you. And once you click on Add Printer again, it will look for all the local printers and select the printer that you want. Selected mine. Click on Continue. Type in the name for your printer. I'll type in HP at RPi. Give it a good description and give the location if you want to. And click on Share this printer. Click on Continue. And just wait, because it will populate with all the list of drivers depending on your vendor or manufacturer of your printer. So there we go. We have got all the list of drivers, and it says the make is HP, which is actually HP, Hewlett Packard. And my model is OfficeJet 5600 series. I've selected the first model, and right after that, I will click on Add Printer. Once you add the printer, you will be sent to the default options page for your printer, and you can set the page size, the printout mode. Like if you want draft quality, you want high quality, you want black and white, etc. You can also select the quality, like 300 dpi, 600 dpi. If it's a really old printer, it should be 300 dpi, but if you don't know, then just select control by printout mode. And you can also add banners like classified, confidential, something like that on top. And you can even have policies. And once you have set all these settings, the default options, you can just click on set default options. And now we will just click on our printer and we will try printing a test page to see whether it works or not. And you can see it sends the job ID to my printer. And I can control the print job right from my web interface. I can either cancel the job or I can move the job. So I've got my print test page and it works perfectly fine. But guess what? There was nothing like confidential that was printed. So that is something which disappointed me. But this was just printing a test page and getting to know about the default options of my printer. Now we need to go through the settings of Mac and Windows. So let's go about it in just about a minute. Let's go to the settings of Mac. So first we need to go to System Preferences, and then we need to go to Printers and Scanners. Right after that, click on the Add button. And because your printer is connected to the Wi-Fi network that you are connected on, it will automatically detect it and just click on that printer and it will start downloading that driver. So it will take about 5 to 7 minutes depending on your net speed, or it may even take a minute. That's it, and you are all set to go. Now you can print using this printer. So let's try printing something. Let's print some text which I just generated using the lorem ipsum generator, and guess what, it actually shows me the printer that's connected to Raspberry Pi. And I'll click on print and it should start printing. Well, it does take some time to send the command, which is pretty much annoying at times. And you can hear the sound of my printer. It started printing. So there we go, the printout is out, and it does even take some time for the completion to show up on your PC or Mac, which is again a drawback, but that's pretty much fine as long as your printer is wireless, right? So now let's proceed with the Windows settings. For Windows, we need to make some changes in the Samba configuration files of our Raspberry Pi. So we'll use the Nano editor to edit these files, and we will go to the location that is /samba/smb.conf. Once the configuration file loads up, you need to copy and paste the text that is given in the description of the video. And once you have done that, press Ctrl+W and search for work group. Now change this work group to the work group that your Windows PC belongs to. And if you have done that, then that's good enough. Usually it is work group itself, but if you are not sure, then go into your control panel and find your domain name. And second, you need to also make Win support, that is, you need to add in Windows support and you need to change it to yes. And once you have done that, press Ctrl+X, press Y and press Enter. Once we have edited the Samba configuration file, we need to restart the Samba configuration file. So we will type in sudo /etc/init.d/samba/restart. And once you do that, Samba will restart, and now it's time to proceed with the Windows operating system settings. Open control panel by searching for it. Now go to hardware and sound. Click on advanced printer setup. It will automatically look for printers in the local network. Select the printer that is connected to your Raspberry Pi and click on next. And now it may say that there's no driver found. Click on OK and select the driver from the drop down menu by selecting the manufacturer first and then the model of your manufacturer. But it is completely possible that your driver may not be listed in this drop down menu. So to avoid those issues, what you should do is connect your printer directly to your Windows PC using the USB port and let the Windows operating system automatically download the driver, or just download the driver from the vendor's website. And after that, repeat this entire process with the Raspberry Pi and you will be able to find the driver in the drop down menu. This was the same issue which I faced, and my driver was not visible, but I followed this procedure and it worked perfectly fine. Select the driver and it should start setting up your printer on your Windows machine. Now click on next and click on finish. Let's try printing some test page. I visited India's government website and let's try printing this particular page through the printer which is connected to my Raspberry Pi. And in the destination you can see it shows me Raspberry Pi HP @RPi, and I'll just click on print and it should just start printing. That's it with this video, guys. I hope you liked it. So please stay tuned for new updates and new videos. I know I have not been making many videos for a long period of time, but I soon expect myself to continue with the videos and tutorials. And I hope you will rate, comment, subscribe and like the video. So please do that and visit techbarrack.com.